First of all, thank you all very much for having me. Kind of wrote down a few things I wanted to say here today. I got asked yesterday to come by and see you guys, and I was ecstatic, so I'm very, very excited to be here. Although I did write some notes, but I'm not going to hand them in, because if I did, I'd probably lose points for neatness. So I'll keep them to myself. So I did scratch some things down. Some of my friends here have already mentioned that I was in the Canadian Forces prior to becoming a police officer. So I did 12 years of service. Served in three different provinces, in multiple different countries, did a combat tour in Afghanistan. Part of my job when I was there, I was a police officer in the military as well, was to help train the local police forces there, how to maintain security in their country. It's a very difficult job as a country where, like you say, kids can't go to school or be out on their own. Didn't have the freedom that we have here. So just basic things, just like getting people to show up to work and actually put on the uniform. Oftentimes people wouldn't show up because they were too afraid of the enemy finding out that they were trying to secure their country. So imagine a place where it's so dangerous and that people are getting scared to stand up. I was asked to talk to you guys a little bit about Remembrance Day. So I've been involved in quite a few of these things over the years. I do have some notes from some previous things. So like I said, I did some scratching. So it's a time of when people get together to remember those that sacrificed their life. That's already been mentioned, obviously. But we also get together to remember those that survived as well. Remember the people that did come home. World War I, the fields were so battle-torn, they didn't grow food. Didn't even grow grass, but after the war was over, the poppies did grow in these fields. So we wear those poppies as a symbol of remembrance. The wreath of poppies is laid in honor of war, so on the 11th day, 11th month, 11th hour, we pay our respects in the moment of silence to remember those soldiers that didn't come home or make it back. But that being said, we're lucky to live in a safe environment. We have water here, we have food, we have phones. We have lots of trees in our parks. We have quality homes that we live in with heat. We have hospitals. If your home catches on fire, we have fire stations, people will come help you. We have police, like myself, to help keep us safe. We have cars, we have buses to drive us to school. During war times, you can't go to school because it's not safe. At night, you turn your lights off and you hide inside so that enemies can't find you. Because if they do, they would hurt you. During war, when countries are in a place of unrest, you can't follow your dreams. You can't want to become famous. You can't want to even work in your town. These things are not options. So we have to really be thankful for people that fought for us before today and continue to do so that we can do these things. For me, I know it's been 100 years, as been mentioned, since the end of the First World War. Remembrance Day does affect me very much, so I have my own experiences. I've lost friends to conflict, both overseas and after they came back. Both my great-grandparents fought in World War I, both my grandparents fought in World War II. My grandpa, my dad's side, spent 5 years in the trenches fighting with the British Army in World War I. He did come back, but he was very hurt and died as a young man. But I was also asked to speak to you guys about how the police and the military work in times of crisis. So for the last 29 years, Canadian police have contributed to international missions through the United Nations to help maintain the international peace and security around the world. Since 1989, more than 3,800 Canadian police officers have been part of over 66 United Nations missions. These are peacekeeping missions, and they collaborate also with military forces around the world to help create security so they can again, go to school and have food and have homes and nice places to play. Recently, a member of our police service, Sergeant Mark Bloxham, he returned just past August from United Nations missions to the Middle East. They were working with the region to help build security. They were building schools, police stations, training police officers how to go out, keep their community safe, which is a very important job and it's an ongoing battle. World War I was supposed to be the war that ended all the wars. We know now that's not true. There's been many conflicts since. And those conflicts even continue here in our own community. You guys may not be aware of it, the police service gets about 1 million calls for service every year from people looking for us to help them. Currently right now, I just checked my car before I came inside. The Edmonton Police Service right now is just cresting over 107,000 criminal investigations in Edmonton. So if you can imagine the amount of calls we're going to and the amount of effort that it takes to keep you all safe, to make sure that you have the right to choose who you want to be, where you want to go, where you want to go to school, what you want to wear, things like that. These are all things that we take for granted, but there are lots of conflicts out there and people that would love to disrupt our security. And so even though we are police and we like to keep everybody safe, we also are trained in military tactics and things like that we can deploy right here at home. So I'm not sure if you guys may not be aware of the constant battle we're doing to keep you guys safe. That's why it's nice for me to come to things like this and see all your nice faces and know that you guys are doing good and you're happy in your school and you're safe here. So once again, thank you very much for having me come speak with you. And I'll pass back to you.